الله أكبر الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا داعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أما بعد فيا أيها الإخوان أوصي لنفسي ولكم جميعا بتقوى الله عز وجل قال الله تعالى في كلامه المجيد وفرقانه الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله قولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وقال الله تعالى والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون وقال تعالى قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من ستر مسلما ستر الله له يوم القيامة متفق عليه إخواني الكرام خلاني الإبام respected brothers and sisters in Islam it is great blessing after a long time our sisters are with us and they are praying Alhamdulillah with us and it is blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala This Ramadan, I hope it was very enjoyable Ramadan of Mubarak. And all we fast, even it was the month of the blessing and month of the fasting and month of the Quran, and we feel it. And all we are, Alhamdulillah, we fast. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is my hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has forgiven us. But after the Ramadan al-Mubarak, shaitan is open. And shaitan is open enemy for everyone. You see, most of the time, when you go to the movie center, you will not see anything problem there. But when you come to the masjid and madrasa and Quranic classes, you will see a lot of problem. And some people, they ask, Huzur, what will happen? Always we see you have a problem. I say, you know why? Because shaitan always behind us. And shaitan was not behind the Namrud and Fir'aun. Shaitan was behind the Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And shaitan was behind the Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Shaitan was behind the Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why on the day of judgment, even all people will go to the Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and say, make the request to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should start the hisab and kitab. Whatever decision he wants to make it. Then Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, no, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wala taqrabu hadhihi ash-shajara. Then I ate that fruit, that's why I cannot go. You can go to the Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. And people will come to the Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. And Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, you will say, no, I cannot go today. Because I made mistake. What mistake I made? Because I made dua for my child, and who was not Muslim, was Kafir, and I made dua for him, and I asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, you promised this truth, why you destroyed my son? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Nuh, la tas'alni ma laysa laka bihi ilm. O Nuh, don't ask me any question which you have no knowledge. Innahu laysa min ahlik. He is not from your family. Because he is not in Islam. And people will come to the Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam will say the same thing. And people will come to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he will say the same thing. My dear respected Muslim Ikram, who can say I am not sinner? Who can say I am not sinner? I don't commit any sin. Sometimes we are sinful, we do knowingly and sometimes unknowingly. It is happening every time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready to forgive us until the last breath of our life. When Bardar will come, before that if we make tawbah, it is accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why always, whenever, you know, sometimes we are committing sin or we are doing something injustice with our wife, with our children. Sometimes imam doing injustice with the Muslims, and sometimes leaders are doing the injustice with their followers. And you know that is happening. But what is the remedy? Remedy is we have to ask forgiveness from everybody. And we have to ask, if it is Hakul Ibad, if I hurt someone, then it is my duty to ask forgiveness from the people. And before that, we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Alladheena idha fa'alu al-fahishatan aw zalamu anfusahum zakaru Allah fastaghfiru li dhunubihim wa man yaghfiru adh-dhunuba illa Allah. Who can forgive us? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive us. And when we are committing something which is unlawful with the people, in front of the people, we have to ask forgiveness from people. If I do personally with someone, I have to ask personally someone. If I do in congregation, then I have to ask in congregation, I have to ask, please forgive me. And it is when I ask you, please forgive me, then it is your duty to forgive, then Allah will forgive you. That's why we are Muslim. We are all of our brother, al-Muslimu, akhul-Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in Bukhari, al-Muslim. It is the hadith, al-Muslim akhul-Muslim, la yuslimuhu wa la yuslimuhu. Man kana hajata fihi khatatana Allah hajatu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if we are sometimes, you know, we are Muslimin, we are brother. You know, sometimes we are our sister, sometimes we are committing sin, we are doing unjust. And if we don't, then it is our duty to ask. That's why always, I am very much humble to you. Sometimes, you know, knowingly or unknowingly, I do sometimes which I should not do. It happened. Then your duty, when this is freely I am telling each and every one of our Muslims, if you see I made mistake in Salah, what you do? You have to say, Subhanallah. But sometimes you can say, Allahu Akbar. Then Imam know that he made mistake. Then what he used to do? He have to make this sources. Because Imam, he made mistake. What is remedy? Remedy is there, we have to make the sources. That is the way we have to do. And all we have to think, no matter what, you are Hanafi, you are Shafi, you are Hanbali, you are Maliki, you are Ahle Hadith or Ahle Quran, whatever you are. But if you are Muslim, then I am your brother. If you are Muslim, if you say La ilaha illallah, Aqeen and Betalbet, then I am your brother. If I ask you forgive me, your duty is you have to forgive me. That's why I am asking you. Sometimes I do mistake. And it is your, I am asking you, please, all the time, whenever you see my mistake, it is your duty. Come to me and say, Imam, you did not do this. This is not right. You should not do this. You are my Imam. Even if your father, when you do what you do, you have to go to the father. Father, you should not do it. This is unlawful. Our children, they are very open. They are saying everything. Our children are very open. They are saying. But when we were in the child, we did not have the chance to say anything to our parents. But our children, they can say, MashaAllah, Alhamdulillah. And it is my duty to each and every Muslim. No matter what, you are thinking I am your brother or not, but I am thinking I have all hope you are my brother. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-Muslimu akhul Muslim. Muslim is the brother of the Muslim. Innama al-Muslimun ikhwa. Innama al-Mu'minun ikhwatun. All the Muslims are brothers. That's why if you, whenever I make mistake, I am asking you, don't keep in your mind. Just ask for me, forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number second, if we make any mistake with our family members, we have to ask them, please forgive. And tell even my wife, even my children, even my nephew, or our grandchildren, then we have to ask, please forgive me. They will learn how to ask the forgiveness from others. And you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always ready to forgive us. That's why this ayah, you know, very famous in the Quran. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Oh my prophet, tell my servants, my ibad, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. They should not be hopeless from my rahmah and blessing. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jamia. Surely Allah is ready to forgive all their sins. Innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. Surely He is most forgiving, most merciful. And this ayat, when that ayat came, you know, the kuffar Makkah, mushrikeen, they committed sin and they made jina, adultery, they killed people. They made load of sin and they made unjust to each and every one. And they said, O Prophet of Allah, you whatever dawah you are making to us, it is good. But we have committed sin. What sin? Having this love, everything we done. If we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now and we have iman, then Allah is ready to forgive. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was quiet. Then this ayat came, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. And there is another ayat in Surah Al-Furqan. Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَإِنْ إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you are committing sin and asking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah only, he's not forgiving you. He, instead of your sin, He's writing their hasan. This is the ayat came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected Muslim ikram, Alhamdulillah, all your sins, kullu bani Adam khatta'un, all the bani Adam, they are sinful. They are active sin. But khayru khatta'un at-tawwabun. He is the best. As a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is always making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I am making tawbah myself. And you have to make tawbah to yourself. And whenever I make something wrong, think I am your brother and forgive me, please. When I made this mistake with an ill feel, I made a mistake unknowingly. You know, unintentionally I made a mistake. Immediately after, I called that person. I said, please forgive me. And he said, you know, Imam, I know you. I know you. Don't tell me like that, please. I know you and I have forgiven. And I ask you, if you have any kind of hard feeling for me, like I made mistake, please forgive me, please. Because if you are not forgiving, Allah is not going to forgive you. That's why it is my duty to ask you, and your duty you have to forgive me. And always, because I am in front of you, warn your eyes towards me, but my eyes towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My gaze in the place of sister, but your eyes, all of you are seeing me. And my mistake always happened because I am the servant of Allah, and like human you are. And listen to you, I am your khadim, I am your brother. That's why, my dear respected Muslim Ikram, always we should have the relationship between you and us. It is we are brother. Nothing else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, nothing else. Believers are the brother of the believers. And whenever we make mistake, if you see or you make mistake, you have to come to me. If I make mistake, openly I have to say I made mistake. Please forgive me. And if I make mistake, it is not, blame should not go to the committee or anybody. Blame should go to who make mistake. And it is my request to each and every one. If you are with Tawbah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is a good news. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارَ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ كُلِّ بَيْتٍ مَخْرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ حَمٍّ فَرَزًا وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever always making istighfar and tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever you are making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready to forgive you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a chance. And whatever hardship you have in your life, Allah will remove it. And whatever thinking, bad thinking you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove that. And Allah will give you rest. Rest meaning in your money, your car, your house, your everything. Allah will give you. From where you cannot even think. See, this COVID-19 happened. It is lot of brother and sister, they are jobless. But anybody has any problem? Alhamdulillah. I see, you know, before COVID-19, it happened from China virus, it happened, you know, before that, it was not too easy for us, those who are low income people. It is for us, Allah made easy. And those brothers are serving for us, Allah give them Iman and Amal Salih. And it is our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, my dear respected Muslim Ikram, we have to pray for each and every one. I ask your prayer and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me and for whole Ummah of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفر الله وأتوب إليك. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا داعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أما بعد فيا أيها الإخوان أوصي لنفسي ولكم جميعا بتقوى الله وجل قال الله تعالى في كلامه المجيد وفرقانه الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu sallu alaihi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin abdika rasulik wa salli ala al-mu'minin wal-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat wa barik ala Muhammadin wa azwajihi wa dhurriyyatihi. Qala an-nabiy sallallahu alaihi wa sallam arhamu ummati bi ummati Abu Bakr radhiyallahu ta'ala. Asyadu fi amrillah Umar radhiyallahu ta'ala. Asdakum haya'an Usman radhiyallahu ta'ala. Aqdahum Ali bin radhiyallahu ta'ala. Aqatibatu sayyidatu nisa'i ahli jannah. Al-Hasan wal-Husayn sayyida shababi ahli jannah. Allahumma gfir al-Abbas walidihi maghfiratan zahiratan wa batinatan la tubadilu zamba. Allah Allah fi ashabi la tattakhidhum qaradan min ba'di. Faman ahabbahum fa bihubbi ahabbahum. Waman abghadahum fa bihubbi abghadahum. Wa khairu ummati qarni thumma alladhina yalunahum thumma alladhina يلونهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أيد المسلمين والمسلمات، اللهم أنصر المجاهدين في الدين الذين يجاهدون في فلسطين يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار، يا كريم يا ستار، يا أرحم الراحمين، تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وقيامنا يا رحمن يا رب العالمين. يا الله يا شكر من شوال يا رب العالمين، تقبل منا صيامنا وزواج قيامنا يا الله. تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم. تقبل منا صلاه الجمعه مع جماعه المصلين الحاضرين يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد واله واصحابه اجمعين. وارحمنا معهم، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني اذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون.